One of the really fun things about this project was how we figured it out. We found that DNA sequences, like those that are collected all the time in genetic studies, actually have information about a biological process.
So far, people have been sequencing genomes to study variation and study disease, but we found that these genome sequences actually contain information about DNA replication timing in those cells.
We can essentially capture the replication of the genome in a snapshot. So it has information about DNA replication processes that were active in that person's cells at the moment DNA was extracted from them.
Different parts of the genome have different amounts of DNA based on when those regions replicate.
The early replicating parts of their genomes are actually more abundant. There's more DNA from them. And we realized that we could use that to make personalized replication timing maps from large numbers of people. One of the most basic things a cell needs to do is to replicate its genome when it divides into two cells. When we replicate our genomes, we don't just replicate chromosomes from one end to the other. Our cells start at many places in the middle of the chromosomes that are called origins of replication. And the parts of the genome that are near an origin replicate early, and the parts that are far from an origin replicate late. The nature of that program is very important because the early phases of genome replication can be slow and careful, but the late phases are fast and mutation prone.
They start by replicating the most important parts, which are the genes, and continue with the rest of the genome, which might get higher rates of mutation.
So it's important to replicate the most important parts of your genome relatively early. And our cells have figured this out. They have evolutionary programs for doing it.
We discovered that different people replicate their DNA in slightly different ways.
And that natural inherited genetic variation shapes what those DNA replication programs look like.
Replication timing can influence mutation rate in different regions in different people, and as a consequence, lead to a higher risk of disease in certain people compared to other people. So I think this work is important because it reveals a new form of variation in humans, and this form of variation could influence the rate of mutation in different people, which could influence both evolution and disease risk.
Now we need to figure out how this works, how genetic sequence variants distort replication timing, and what this contributes to human disease.